Hi everyone and welcome back. In this video we are going to talk about object copy. So this is always a very important question, either you do with the array, object, anything. So there can be a possible question, okay, how can you copy one array into another, how can you merge two different array, how can you copy an object into another object. Now there is a deep copy, shallow copy concept. Deep copy means if you are copying one object into another object, then whenever you change the primary object, that secondary object should not change. Okay, shallow copy is where you have a nested object, you are doing a copy, you will get a new object, but the nested properties will only be copied with reference. It means if you change the nested properties from object A, then object B will also be impacted. Okay, so we have object assigned, we have a spread operator, dot 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 operator. Like if I wanted to create an array which is a copy of existing array, then I can just use dot array, right? If I wanted to get a copy of an object, then I can say obj equal to, this is my existing object, I can do dot 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 obj. Okay, if I wanted to use object dot assign, then obj1 equal to object dot assign. So we have different methods, object dot assign, create and all. Assign means when you want to create a new object and it does shallow copy. So this is your existing object you have, you are passing it. So it will give you the new object. If you have only root level object, I mean your object is pretty much simple, which is plain, like this is your obj. And this is how it look like, where you have x70, y90. It's a root level object, doesn't have a nested objects or nested properties. Then it will do a deep copy. But if when you get a nested objects, like okay, I have a Z which is having nested object and having the nested properties or something like this, then this object will be copied as a reference. So object.assign will not help, object or this spread operator will not help in that case. What we can do is we can actually write our own methods to copy. So in this case we can write our own clone object. You can say it is taking object as an argument and it is returning a clone object, right? So what we are doing is we are iterating onto the properties using foreign loop on this object, and we are checking each and every property. If that is not an object, directly assign it. If that is an object, then recursively call this clone object. This is very standard problem, standard question in most of the interviews. How can you do the deep copy? You can also use json.stringify and convert the existing object into a string and parse it back. Or Lodash and all also provide a deep clone method. But if you want to copy it iteratively, then this is how you can create a new object. So this is how we can create a new object, and this is how you can do a deep copy. This is a clone object method you can write. I mean, you can do it in multiple ways. Here we are just iterating on an object and checking if it is an object, then recursively call it, or otherwise just assign the target object with the same property from the source object. Okay, that's it guys. Let's talk about more questions in the next video.